again, welcome back you all to the online classes. So, you all know that now we are discussing about the wealth of India, that is the 6th unit of your SST part. And in that we have now started the second chapter, that is mineral resources of India. Right? So, mineral resources. So, now just we can recall something what you have learned in the previous class. Okay. So now tell me, what are the kinds of minerals? How many kinds are there? Yes, there are two kinds of minerals. So which are those? One is metallic mineral and another one is non-metallic mineral. So there are two kinds of minerals. One is metallic mineral and another one is non-metallic mineral. So metallic minerals are those we can extract the metals from them. Okay, from the metallic minerals we can extract the metals. But the non-metallic minerals, they are not the metallic minerals and they are not have any metallic shining. And they are hard, but they are brittle, means they can break easily. So these are the non-metallic minerals. An example for the metallic minerals are iron, copper, zinc, manganese, silver, gold. So like there are some examples for the metals, metallic minerals. And some example for non-metallic minerals are sand, limestone, coal, petroleum, gypsum. So these are some non-metallic minerals. And already we have learned in our previous class that about the metallic minerals, their uses as well as where they are occur, means the deposits of the metallic ore. So about this all we have learned in our previous class in detail. And in our today's class, we are going to discuss about some non-metallic minerals. Okay. So now, in this class, we can learn about the non-metallic minerals. So, non-metallic minerals, these are the minerals from they do not have any metallic shine and they can break easily because they are brittle in nature. Brittle means the substance is hard but they can break easily. For example, if you take any silicon materials like your teacups and all, silicates, the teacup and all, so if you throw it, it will be broken very easily. And even in the glass which is manufactured by the sand, the silicates are used there. So if you throw it, it will break very easily. So that they are brittle, they are hard but they are brittle, they can break easily. Okay, so they are the non-metallic minerals. And now we can discuss some of the non-metallic minerals. And in that, the first one is the limestone. Production of cement and also it is used in the purification of ऑन डिपॉजिट्स इन इंडिया दे आर मध्य प्रदेश महाराष्ट्र the cement, in the manufacturing of the cement. Okay, so mainly it is used to make the cement and the chemical fertilizers. So the gypsum, it is a non-metallic mineral and mainly it is used to make the cement and also it is used to make the chemical fertilizers. And you might now know that one chemical fertilizer is there, its name itself, the gypsum, right? So the uses of this gypsum are, it is used to make cement and also it is used to make chemical fertilizers. Chemical fertilizers. So these are the uses of the gypsum. And the deposits of gypsum in India. Deposits of gypsum in India are Rajasthan, Uttarakhand and Tamil Nadu. Rajasthan, Uttarakhand and Tamil Nadu. So these are the states where we can get the abundant. Abundant means in the huge fall. We can found the gypsum in these states in the huge fall, in the abundant fall. Okay. So that means in the excess amount. We can found the gypsum in these states such as Rajasthan, Uttarakhand and Tamil Nadu. So this is about the gypsum. So gypsum is a non-metallic mineral and its uses are to make cement and to make the chemical fertilizers. And some deposits of gypsum in India are Rajasthan, Uttarakhand and Tamil Nadu. So these are the deposits of gypsum. And see, the non-metallic minerals not only comprises these, even many other non-metallic materials are also there, such as asbestos, diamond. You know the diamond is a very precious stone, and also many precious stones and gems. Okay, so they are all in comprises the non-metallic minerals. Other than these, limestone, gypsum, mica, sand and all, some other non-metallic minerals are also there. They are asbestos and diamond and many other precious stones and gems. They are all comprises the non-metallic minerals. So see, one final is there in your textbook. That is, diamond is also a mineral. And find some information about this important precious gem, right? The diamond. You might have seen that diamond cuts diamond, right? Have you heard about this? Diamond cuts diamond because we are not able to cut the diamond by any of the equipment because it is such a hard. It is made up of the carbon, so it is very. It is such a hard that we cannot. It cannot break. What we said in the earlier. So the non-metallic minerals, they are not having the metallic shine and they are easily break, right? But the diamond is such a hard that it cannot able to, we are not able to break it as easily. example, we can say the sodium and potassium. So they are also the metals, but they are very soft metals. You don't know the sodium. Sodium is a metal. It is such a soft, you know. It is like your eraser. How the eraser is soft, no? So like that, the sodium is there. So sodium and potassium, they are the, even though they are the metals, they are very soft. So likewise, even though all the non-metals are brittle, means they can break easily, the diamond, it is very hard. We cannot break it. So it is one of the very precious gem, and we all know that it is used in the jewels, right? In the jewels, we can use the diamonds with the gold and all. So this is used for making the jewels and all. Right, this is about what? The precious non-metallic mineral, that is diamond. Okay. And one thing you have to remember that these all the non-metallic minerals, what are they? They are all non-renewable. They are exhaustible sources. Exhaustible means once if we use the minerals, once if we use, they will be buried, they will be exhaust, they will be completely vanished once when we use. They will not be replenished, or we are not able to recover, or we are not able to get them back. ಒಂದು ಸತಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಖಾಲಿ ಆಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ವಾಪಸ್ ನಮಗೆ ಈ ಸನ್ಲೈಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಸಿಗುವ ಹಾಗ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಸಿಗೋದಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ದೀಸ್ ಮಿನರಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ನಾನ್ ರಿನಿವೇಬಲ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಸ್ಟಿಬಲ್. ಒನ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ವಿ ಯೂಸ್ ದೆಮ್, ದಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ಲಿ ಬರಿ, ವಿ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ದೆಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಥಿಂಕ್ ವೈಸ್ಲಿ and use the proper amount of all the minerals, right? So this is about the non-metallic minerals, and also many other non-metallic sources also there. We can discuss about that now. They are the fuels.
Houses.
anything that emits heat or energy, heat or energy when burnt, is called fire. So anything that emits heat or energy when burnt is called fire. So when we burn the fire, it will produce the heat or the energy in the form of anything. So that we call as the fire. Okay, example are the petrol. The petrol, diesel, the natural gas, the kerosene, coal. So they are all called the fires. So when we burn the fuels, so they will produce the heat and they will emit some energy. So that we call as the fuel. Right? And see, when we burn these fuels, we use the fossilized energy, and that fossilized energy will be the solar energy which is absorbed by the plants and animals when they are alive, before dying. When they are alive, they absorb some solar energy, and that is only what we can say the fossilized energy. When we burn this fuel, the energy what we use, that we term as the fossilized energy, and that fossilized energy is actually the solar energy which is absorbed by the animals and plants when they are alive. And see, now we can discuss how the fossil fuels are formed with the diagrammatical representation. So now we can learn how fossil fuels are formed. How fossil fuels are formed. Right? So we all are using the fossil fuels in very excessive manner. So we know many vehicles we are using now, the heavy engines are there and also the light engines. So we are using petrol, diesel. For heavy engines we use the diesel, right? And also in some of the industries also we use, and in generators, right? We use fossil fuels in all these areas. So how these fossil fuels are formed? So in your textbook it is given diagrammatically. So now I will explain how these fossil fuels are formed. Okay, now see that. So it is there in your textbook. Just open page number 252. Yes. Have you taken the textbooks? We started providing all the textbooks. Yes. So if you did not get your textbooks still, you just come and take your textbooks. So see, this is the diagram which shows the formation of fossil fuels. So see, in the first diagram, the trees, ferns and other plants die and decay and become silt. So see, when the ferns, trees and other plants are die, so they all decay and become the silt here. And later the plants and marine creatures, so even many animals are there in the water also. So what about those marine plants and animals? So those plants and animals, any creatures, are die and sink into the seabed. So seabed will be there. So under the sea, some ground part will be there. So there, these all the dead and decaying matter of these marine life, it will sink towards the seabed. And then they get buried under the layers of sand and mud. So there the layers of sand and mud will be there. So under the layers of there, they buried. And then what happened? Gradually over several million years. So it is not an easy process, and it will not take place in 1 or 2 years. It takes millions of years. So what happened then? After several million years, they heaten sorry, they harden and become part of the earth's rock. Yes, they will become hard when they buried under the sand and layer of the rock. So they will hard, they will become hardened and become the part of the earth's rock. And the part remains become the plant parts. The plant remains, what are they? They become the coal, and the other animals waste, what is there? The remains of the animals. They will become the oil, such as petroleum and all. So here the pressure, the weight of the rock and heat, bacteria and chemical conditions slowly convert the remains of the organisms into oil and natural gas. So likewise, the fossil fuels are formed. And see, the natural gas, since it is in the form of gas, it will be form a upper layer, and below that we can get the crude oil, right? And see, this is what the well to get the fossil fuels. So while some of the gas move upwards and escapes, a large part of it is gets trapped by layers of the rock. As some of the gas, it will be escapes, but some part will be remain in the rock part only. So now, though that is where it traps, where it remains trapped for centuries, and now oil companies, they are searching for it with the help of geologists. We know that the geologist, so they will help in the searching of all these mineral resources. So now they are the oil companies, they are with the help of geologists, they are now searching for the gas which is left in the rocks. So this is what about the fuels. And now see, we know that these are all the non-renewable resources. So non-renewable means once if we use, so that will be vanishes. So we are not able to recover them again. So only once we can use them. The petrol, if you use once, can you recover it again? No, it will be over and it will produce the heat energy or light energy. So it will be over then. And if we burn, we can use all these fossil fuels in the production of electricity also. So when we use this in the production of electricity, we can burn the coal, right, in the thermal power plants. So the thermal power plants are there. Thermal power plants. So in the thermal power plants, the heat energy is converted into electrical energy. So for the production of electricity, we use the heat energy, and that heat energy is produced by the coal. So in the thermal power plants, we use the coal in a very large amount. So that, but also we know that the coal is the non-renewable resource. But still we use the coal in the large amount in the thermal power plants for the production of electricity. So that we can get the electricity and we can supply that electricity to the homes, offices and all. Likewise, according to the production. So this is what we are using the natural resources for that. So when we use the large amount of coal in the thermal power plant for the production of electricity, so that all will be buried. So again, it will take several million years to form the coal. So that we have to use the whatever the natural resources are there, which are exhaustible, so which cannot be renewable, so that we have to use in the minimum amount, means depending on the necessity. So in the large amount we should not use. And other than that, see here, coal, why we are using? For the production of the electricity. There are other ways are also there for production of electricity. We can use that. Why do we go for coal? Even for the coal, there are many harmful effects are also And other than that, some of the renewable resources are there, such as light energy is there, wind energy, water energy. So we can use that. So from the solar energy, the energy from the sun. From that also, by using the solar panels, we can get the electricity. We can produce the solar energy from that. We can produce the electricity. And also from the water. So water turbines and generators will be there. From that we can convert that into electrical energy. And also the windmills are there. So huge fans will be there. And from that, when they started rotating, that mechanical energy will be converted into electricity. Right? And also this sun and water, as well as the wind, they are the renewable sources. They can be replenishes. Even though we can use, we get the same amount of the sunlight, water and wind. So we can use that. And also we can go for the biogas. Yes, they what we are doing, from the waste of the animals, the animal dung and all, from that, by the worms, by using the red worms and all, we made to decompose it, and we have to maintain optimum pressure and temperature so that it produces the gas. And that we can use for the production of gas as well as for the domestic purpose, like the gas for our food cooking and all. Right? So this is what we have to use, some eco-friendly manners. Right? So this is about your mineral resources of India. So with this, I will conclude this chapter. I hope you have understood. Even though, if you have any queries, you can contact me and clarify our doubts. Thank you. Have a nice day.